Hi guys, I hope you guys are doing well. So in today's lecture I am going to teach you the easiest way how we can create a library image picker controller. Okay, so generally the iPhone SDK provide us to pick a single image from the library gallery. Okay, so suppose I have a scenario like I need to pick multiple photos at a time from our photo library. So how can we achieve in easiest way, in easy steps, whatever we want, we can customize that library, okay, as per our requirement. Okay, so let's start. I am going to create a new application. So just go to the file and create a new project. Okay, so just I am giving a name as a gallery picker. Okay, then next, and just I am saving that. Okay, so this is created. Now I am creating a layout, how it should look like when we'll fetch the photos from library. So that will be our custom library. Okay, so just I am taking a UI collection view, one collection view here. So just drag and drop, and I am adjusting the height and width of this one. Okay, so so this is the collection view. Okay, before that, what we can do, we can create this in here. We can delete this. Here we can simply add one button. Okay, so we'll fetch some images from here. So here we can add one button. Okay, just button here I'm adding, and I'm saying open. I'm changing the title as a open gallery. Okay, from here itself we'll open our gallery. Okay, after clicking on this button we'll open. So I'm taking one more controller. Okay, so just I'm taking one more controller, and from here I will open our gallery. So just I'm adding the action, segue action. So I will say as present modally of this. Okay, then I'm going to add one navigation bar over to that. Okay, this I have added navigation bar, and I am going to set the constraint for that. Okay, so it's done. Now I am going to add a collection view for that. So this is the collection view. Now I am going to adjust the height and width of this. Okay, so let's go beyond that. Just I want up to here. Okay, now I'm going to set the layout of this one. So just top left, all those things I will set. So it's edit. Now I'm going to add one button here. That button will say done button or something. Okay, so just I will change from here. I will say done button. Okay, now it's done. Now I'll create one controller for this. So here simply I'll create one controller file here. I'll say gallery view controller BC. Okay, so it's from UI view controller. So it's already taking the view controller. I'll remove this. I'll say gallery BC and next and save. Okay, this is created. Now what I'll do, I'll add the controller name here. It's added. Now I'll add the story board file name if we'll require further things. Okay, now I'll add the action for this done button here. Oops, manually I need to go to that path. So gallery view controller. Now I'll add the action for this. So I'll simply drag and drop from here by using the control select. I'll say this to as a done press or something, some action I have taken. Okay, so it's added. Now what I'll do, just simply I'll run this and we'll add one table view here. So what we'll do, we'll open a custom gallery from here, this one, and here we'll fetch the images. So this will be the our library view here, and we'll pick the images and display here. Okay, so this is created. Now what we need to do, we need to create some methods that will fetch the list of images from the gallery and the some kind of data fetching method. So I'll create one gallery manager here. Okay, so let me create quickly one class. I'll say gallery manager. Okay, so I'll created one gallery manager. Okay, and say class gallery manager. Okay, I don't want any super class here. Okay, I'll create one shared instance for that. Let shared. Okay, I'll say gallery manager. Okay, now I'll make it as a pure singleton. So I will privately override the init method, so nobody can create another instance of this. Okay, this is done. Now I will define some two or three methods. So first method I will define, that will be the fetching the number of we can say images. Okay, so that will be fetching by using the ph assets. Okay, so we'll add here photo framework. Okay, inside that the things are defined. Okay, by using that ph assets is there. Okay, we'll mainly use the ph assets and the what else we'll use, psns fetch required we'll going to use. Okay, so let me write one method, that's a function get list of assets. Okay, so it will return the all list of assets. Okay, so here we'll write and it will return the all assets list to us. Okay, so what we'll do, we need to check the permissions. One thing we need to check the permissions first, if the photo library have the permissions or not. Okay, so we'll use the ph photo library. Okay, dot we'll say authorization, we'll say request for authorization. Okay, and it say here status, we'll say status. Okay, and then whatever status will get, to that we will add some switch case, and I'll say the status here is status, and I'll put that all the cases, like I'll say case 1 dot authorized, I'll say case 2 dot denied. Okay, I'll say case dot and I'll say denied and not determined. Okay, mainly I'm adding those three cases. Okay, mainly these three cases I'm going to add. Okay, this, so this is added. Now I'll add the break. Okay, cool. So okay, what it's that switch must consider default. We have not added default case because one case is pending, so let me add that also. Case dot authorized, denied and restricted. So I'll add that restricted also, okay, and I'll say break. So now the warning will goes away. Okay, now here what we will do, we will create whenever that is authorized. Okay, so we will create one fetch option. Okay, we will create one fetch options. Okay, what will be the options whenever we are fetching? Okay, so we'll create the fetch options. So let me create let fetch options. So let me create the let fetch options equals to ph fetch options. So it's there. I'll create of this ph fetch options. I've created. Now we need one ph image manager and the ph request options. Okay, so let me create one manager. So what we can do, we can create a manager globally. Okay, so let me put here itself the manager. So I'll say where gallery manager. So I'll say some image manager here, image manager, and that I will give the type as ph image manager. Okay, I'll keep it optional, and then I'll say here ph request options. So I'll say options. Okay, and this I will give as a ph image options request options. Okay, and that also I'll take as optional, and whenever this will initialize, I'll say self dot image manager equals to ph image manager dot default. Okay, and self dot I'll say the options equals to I'll say ph image request options, ph image request options, and then select. So whenever that shared instance will create, will give those options here. So this currently is not required here. I'll tell you when we can use this. Okay, this is done. Now what we'll do, if we have the authorization to access the gallery, then what we can do, simply will fetch the images, okay, from the ph assets library. The number of all assets will fetch. So I'll say ph assets dot, I'll say fetch assets, okay, with a dot image type. We'll say ph assets. Now we need to find out the option where we can put the media type. So I'll say dot image here, because we want all images here. Okay, and this is ph options. Okay, so this one we'll use here, fetch options. Okay, this fetch options we'll use here. Okay, now here we'll get the all assets, ph assets, we'll get here all assets in this. Okay, now what we can do, we can return this asset. So we'll add one completion here. Okay, and in remaining things will return the error. Okay, so let me create one completion here. I'll create one completion block here. Okay, and I'm taking the return type as a void. Okay, now here what I'll say it will return the images or we can say assets, whatever will get here, what will be the type, is will be the ph assets request. I'll say ph fetch request, fetch result, and that will be the type of ph assets. Okay, so this one will return. Okay, now it's saying some things underscore, I'll add. Now what I'll do, I'll say completion, and from here I'll return the whatever assets we have captured from here. Okay, now along with that I'll put comma, I'll say error as well as if we'll get any error, and the type of string. So in other blocks, and I keep this as a optional value. Okay, and this one also as a optional value. Okay, so here it's asking to escape that, so I'll add the rate of escaping, and here the error will be nil. Okay, there is no error here, and in other blocks will return here some type of error, and I'll say error, and here error, oops, this break I have kept here. Okay, so remove this and remove this, and enter and put this here, and enter and put this here. Okay, and put this here. Okay, so assets, here the assets will be nil, here also the assets will be nil, because this is will get some error here. Okay, and here will it return some error, here also will return some error, so simply will return like denied or something. Okay, so simply I am keeping denied, and here I'll say not determined, here I will say restricted, so this type of error it will return. Okay, when I'll call this method, I will get the all number of assets. Okay, now what I need to do is, like, from the assets I will fetch the thumbnail image. So I will write one method, I will say function get thumbnail, thumb image I'll say. Okay, and I'll add this completion block as it is will required here. So in place of this will return the image. Okay, so in place of that I'll say I will return a image here. Okay, we'll add that here, get thumbnail. Okay, so what it will do, it will receive a assets here. Okay, it will receive a assets. Okay, so it will be the type of ph assets. Okay, it will receive a ph assets, and what it will do, sorry, here it will receive as a argument, here it will receive this assets here. Okay, it will receive assets, and after the completion it will return a image. So I will say image of UI image. Okay, so it will return, I'll give as a optional. So after receiving the ph assets, it will return a UI image. Okay, so let me use the manager, whatever we have created above. So I'll say image manager dot request for image. So I want a image. So what I will say, I will say based on this, I need based on this. So I will say this assets I will pass here, and this target size what we want. Okay, this is completion, and this is ph fetch options. Okay, so use the same options, we don't have some specific things to that. So we already have this ph image fetch options here. So I'll say the options here itself, options I will add here, and after that we'll receive here image. okay, image, and here will receive some keys. Okay, so I'll say some keys here, and this is mode will give a dot, okay, aspect fill. I'll say aspect fill for now. Okay, now we need to put here size, what size we want. So currently I'm taking as a CG size, as a what we can take, let's take as a width and height as a 100 into 100. Okay, so width equals to 100 comma and height equals to 100. Okay, so it will execute and return our image and will check if let non-nil image if we found. Okay, if we found non-nil image, then return the completion. Okay, so I'll say completion, and completion that will return the non-nil image. So from here we'll get the thumbnail image. Okay, now same thing we'll do if we want to take a capture a original image. Okay, so this is based on the size. Okay, we can get, and we can write one method that will return the original image based on assets. So just I'm copying and pasting that same thing here. Okay, and I'll say get original image. Okay, get original. Okay, or I'll say take some full size image, that is some more relevant, full size image. Okay, so here I'll again call the image manager, image manager dot, okay, and then request I will say, okay, what request I want, image data. Now I'll request for the image data. Okay, so I'll use the assets whatever we have, and then I'll say options here, and this handler. Okay, so now this time it will return the data. Okay, some status I'll say, and the orientation it's saying, so I'll take as a image orientation, and its keys here. Okay, and this is assets, and this is option. Okay, and here we can add the orientation of that. Okay, so I think we want the orientation or not, that we can check. Okay, so let's check the orientations. What is that key data string orientation is there, so go there, and left, down, top, right, mirror, up. Okay, fine. Okay, okay, so this orientation is there. Image manager dot request data for image live photo. Okay, fine. So dot orientation orientation. Okay, I'll add it some key here, orientation itself. Okay, so we'll check how the orientation is coming, and if you want to rotate that, we can rotate later point of time whenever we want to use that. Okay, so it will return the data from the assets. We'll get here data, and that data will convert to the image. Okay, so here we'll check if this data is not nil. Okay, non-nil data, will say this data, and then we'll convert to that as a image equals to UI image and define with data. So I'll say non-nil data here. Okay, this one, so I'll say image. Okay, so this is done, our library is done. What this method will fetch the list of assets, and using this method will get thumbnail, and using this method will get the full scale images. So our library is done. Now I'll go back to that gallery controller and add some sort of here. Simply I'll add that fetch method. Okay, so I will add here function fetch all assets. Okay, here, and I'll call this method here self dot fetch all assets. Okay, now from that it will return. Okay, so I'll call that here, that method. I'll say that gallery manager dot shared dot, I'll say get list of assets, and it will return the list of assets here. Okay, so here it will be the assets, and here it will be the status. Okay, I'll get the all assets here. So I'll create one array here. So I will say where all assets. Okay, all assets, and then the type of that assets will be, I'll say the let's check here ph fetch result and assets, this will be the type. Okay, so this will be the type of this one. We'll create here, so this is not required. We'll put like that, and this is optional. Okay, so here we'll get the assets. Oops, giving error because we need to import the photo framework here. Okay, and then we'll say self dot all assets, okay, equals to assets whatever we have got here. So this assets will get here, we'll get all the assets here. Okay, and this we are using the block, so we'll use here some beak. Beak self we can add. Okay, so it will save from the memory leaks. Okay, so this is added, we'll get the all assets list here. Now we need to write the collection view, delegate and data source. So I'll say extension gallery view controller, and I'll say UI table view, sorry, UI collection view data source, and I'll add this, and I'll say number of rows. So number of rows, I'll say return self dot all assets dot count. Okay, I'll return this count, and I'll say function self for row at index path. Okay, so I'll say let cell equals to, I'll say collection view dot dq reusable identifier, and that identifier and index path. Okay, that identifier will create one cell here and then we'll use that identifier. Okay, here. Okay, so let's create one custom class. So let me create one custom class. Okay, let me create one custom class here. So I'll go and I'll say new file here, and I'll say gallery collection view cell, go back, go quartz class and go here and gallery collection view cell, gallery collection view cell. Okay, this one will create and add here. So this is created, collection view cell is created. Now what we will do, we will assign that cell to here. Okay, and go here and give the type, so collection view cell, and we'll give the identifier to that. Okay, so I'm keeping the same as it is. Now I will set the data source and delegate methods. Okay, edit the data source and delegate methods. Okay, it's added. Now I will go back to this controller, gallery controller, and here I will give that reusable identifier as well as, and I'll return that cell, return that cell. Okay, and I'll give as a type of that. So this is done here. Now we'll add some methods to that cell, because here we have got the all assets. Okay, now what we need to do, we need to load the image from that asset. So we'll write here one method, bare assets, assets, and that will be the ph asset. So import the photos ph assets. Okay, and that is optional. And whenever it will did set, set did set, whenever it will did set, so I'll say based on this assets load the thumbnail image. Okay, so I'll say the manager, that gallery manager dot shared manager dot get thumbnail image from that ph asset. So from this assets it will return the gallery image, and that image will get here. Okay, image, and that image we can set here. Okay, that image we can set here. So we'll create one image view here. Okay, and then we'll set that. So UI image view, we'll add image view here, this image view. I've added image view. Okay, now put some center or something. Let me change to direction horizontally and vertically and set, and I'll add the constraint for that. Okay, edit, constraint added. Now I will take the IV outlet for that. Okay, so it's not coming. I'm going to take as manually collection view cell. Now I'll take that IB outlet of this one. So I'll say cell image view, cell image view. Okay, image view. Now I'll add, and then whenever I'll get that image, I will set here self dot cell image view dot image equals to image. That's it. So now it's created. Okay, now let's run and see what is happening. I open the gallery and here I have already written all the stuff. Okay, one thing we have missed, we need to add a key here because we are going to access the library. So I'll add that key here. So I'll say privacy space photo, sorry, it's not privacy. Okay, and here we'll see look for photo library usage. Okay, here give some string like I want or something, that application name gallery. Okay, so we added this. Now let's run what is happening. Oops, run in iPhone 6 because this emulator is already. So just run, build the application and let's see what is happening. And I have already added this and this, it's building. And we have added this. Oh, but nowhere I have called that method assets thing from here. Okay, so let me open. Nothing happened, it's crashed because there is no assets. It's fast from here, but it's, we have forcefully unwrapped that. So let me first write here cell dot assets. I'll say equals to self dot all assets and I'll say index path dot item. Okay, each and every asset will pass through him from here and this will take. Okay, so here it's crashing because of this. Okay, so let me put here some condition. Okay, so let's say rows equals to 0, and if let self dot all assets dot count equals to this, then return the this thing. Okay, or else we can say return the 0. So this is, I think, not required. This one we are not using directly yet. Okay, this we have added, this we have added. We forget one more thing, we need to take a IV outlet of collection view also, so that we can reload after getting the all images. Okay, so picker, and I'll take the this ph assets, and here we'll say collection view. Okay, this one. Now let's run what is happening. Now building and running the application, what is happening. Let me check and see here what is happening here. Okay, so it's asking for the okay. I'll say okay. Now I'm opening the gallery. Okay, so see here I have fetched the images from the gallery. So these are the images available in the gallery. Okay, these are the images. Okay, so this one we can customize anything, whatever we want. we can customize in our way. So we'll change some UI so it will looks better. Okay, so let me customize quickly here. Just I'm closing, and we'll add some here flow layout delegate here, UI collection view, flow layout delegate. So here I will remove the space and put some width and height for that. So let's see, let me go here and let me check size for index path. First thing I will add this, so I will return the cell size. Okay, so here I will add that, and what I want is I will calculate the collection view width, and by that I will show 33 of images. So I will say return CG size of this one. So I will say here let size, let width equals to collection view dot size, oops, collection view dot, why collection view dot size is not coming, collection view dot frame dot size dot width. I'll take that width, and what I'll do, I'll divide by 3 of that. Okay, 3 of that, and I'll say width of that, and I'll say width of that. Okay, this one will take and it will return the size. So now it will show the 33 images each. Okay, let's run and check what is happening. It's building and running. Okay, now I'll open the gallery. So here we go. Oh, oops, still it's not showing 33 images. Okay, because the width is there, but the space is there. So we need to remove the space of left and right. So we'll use one more delegate, this edge insect one. We'll go here, and what I'll do, I'll remove the space of all the element, that is, so I'll return the UI edge insect of this, and I'll say 0 left, 0 right, 0 bottom, and 0 right. Okay, I'll return that. Okay, and this I'll remove and build and run. Let's see what is happening. It's running. Oops, still it's not coming. So let's reduce the some minus of 5, 5, 10 and 15. 15 will reduce and run, and here we go. We'll reduce the left and right space here also, so 0 and 0, and here we go. Come on, it's coming. Building, open the gallery. Now here we go. So it's 33 is coming. Okay, now it's showing 33 images. So this library, whatever we want, we can customize as per our requirement. Okay, whatever we want, we can customize this, whatever is our requirement. Based on our requirement, we can easily customize. No need to use any third party or something. Okay, so now this library is, now what we are going to do, like I will click on that and pick that image, and when I press this done, we'll take that image to that previous view where we want to show the all images. Okay, so add that functionality. Now it's short. So here collection view, and when I click on that, I need to show as a selected for that. Okay, so I'm going to add some sort of method here. Okay, So let me add that. So here one method is there that is called edge selected. So I will overwrite that method, overwrite, okay, and I'll say where edge selected is there, edge selected, okay, and that method I'm going to overwrite, okay. So I'll say set, and I'll say some get, okay. So whenever I will set that method, I will say some new value to that. So I will say okay, so set selected, I will say function set selected, where is that, set selected, okay, set selected, and I will pass the value, so that will be the new value, it's selected, selected. I'll say bool type, and I'll say animated true, okay, animated equals to true, okay. So this is done. Now what I'll say, animated is bool. So whenever I will set that, and here we'll get, okay, so I'll return from get that super, whatever value is there in super, super dot is selected, I will return, and here I will set that. So I will say set selected, and I will say new value, and animated, I will say animated true, I will say, okay. So this one, it will come here, set selected, okay. Set selected, it will come here, and what it will do here is like super dot whatever value we are passing from there to this is, I'll say it's selected, okay, like that, okay. Then we'll update that selection, okay. So we'll get here the value, and then here we will check that value, if that is true then we'll do something, and if that is false then we will do something else, okay. So I'll say edge selected equals to true, then do something, and else do something. So now add one image here, so that will show some selection part here. So let me add one more image here, okay. So I'll add one more image here, and that will show as a selected image, okay. Here we go. So this, okay, now I'll add the constraint for this. Height, width, time, take, fix. And now I'm going to add one image to this, okay, that we will add. I have one image here, so that image I will add here, checked one, okay. I'll add that image here. Oops, here, checked, I added. Now I'll take the IV outlet of that. Where is the cell? Here we go. So this I will tag checked image, checked image, go, okay. So this is done. Now we'll go here and we'll add here something in that cell method. So whenever that is selected means I'll say self dot checked image dot hidden equals to true, and here I will say false. Okay, this is done. Now initially I will hide that image. Okay, hidden. Now let's run and see what is happening. Gallery, and if I click on this, okay, so we need to give that as a multiple selection, so I'll add that thing. Because of that it's not happening, so here I'll say self dot collection view dot multiple selection is there. Allow multiple selection equals to true. Now let's run what is happening here. Open the gallery, and images are coming. Now go here and see whatever I click on, that is coming as a selected. Oops, what is happening? Okay, all is coming as a selected. Okay, so let's go here, let's see what is wrong here. So here I'll say new value and it's selected correct, it selected this, and I'll write here prepare for reuse super dot prepare for reuse, and I will say set selected false. Okay, so whenever it will prepare for reuse, it will set the selected thing. Okay, so what else is pending here? Okay, we have write in this set selected will happen, then it will get that image and it will come here, it will take that self and it's update the selection. It's selected is came here. If it's selected is correct, means it's selected means it's true, selected hidden, then it should be false here. This is the wrong here, and then this should be the true. Okay, correct. Now here we go. Now run and see what is happening. Where is that? Here. Now open the gallery, click on this image. Okay, so see, it's clicking. If you click again, it will deselect. Okay, so it's showing that how we are picking. So this is our custom gallery we have created in this tutorial. Now in next tutorial, that will be the part 2, I will tell you how to take those images to another controller, and there we can display the original images. Okay, so we'll continue the things into the next lecture. Okay, if you like the video, please don't forget to like that video, don't forget to thumbs up the video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Okay, we will discuss the things related to image gallery, how we can fetch the full scale image from this. Okay, so that will be in my next lecture. See you, bye bye.